Hello and welcome, and this video about file management in macOS. You're here because you want to improve this process, maybe, or you're looking for the replacement for Finder, so you're in the right place. I decided to make this video after I found myself with 10 or more opened windows of Finder in my desktop, and
what do you want?
And the process of file management became like a switching back and forth and finding right Finder window, and that's the time I decided I have to figure out this process and I have to do something with that, and probably there's a way to improve that. And I started with Finder, so I was thinking probably there's a way to change some settings to make this process better, and truth be told, after changing some settings, Finder become much more useful. But I decided to find replacement for Finder, and since I use Windows and macOS back to back day by day, so I can tell in Windows there's a lot of cool file managers like Far Manager or Total Commander, and I really like them, and it's two pane file managers, and I was thinking probably I have to find something like that for macOS. And so basically I tried all the file managers I managed to find and install on my Mac. I'll share with you this process so you can choose right file manager for you. And in the part 3, I'll tell you about some small but very useful utilities which has complemented my file management process. And I think that's a good idea to start with setting up Finder, because Finder is already installed to every Mac. And if you don't do any complicated file management, maybe that will be just enough for you. And let's dive in and let's take a look what we can do with that. Okay, let's see what we can do with Finder. Here's the freshly installed macOS with the default settings on Finder, and let's see how we can make it better. Let's go to the Finder settings and let's start with the first tab, General. Here we can choose what we want to see on our desktop. To be honest, I don't want to see anything, so to access to my files I usually use file manager, so we can just disable all of them. Just my preferences, and I don't want to see recent file every time I open Finder, so I'm gonna choose downloads folder. So for me, download folder, it's like an inbox, and every time I open new Finder window, I want to see this folder opened. Another checkbox, open folder in tab instead of Windows. Let's check this out, and it will help us declutter our desktop. Instead of opening more and more Finder windows, it will open just tabs. Probably it will help us declutter our desktop. And we're done here on the general settings, and let's go to the tags. I'm not a huge fan of tags, but for many people it might be helpful to organize their file, and it's especially helpful if you're gonna use smart folders. So we'll talk about it a little bit later, but you can add one more field for your files, and then you can collect files using those tags or filter files using those tags. So basically one file can be only in one folder, but using tags and using smart folder, one file can be populated in many smart folders. So it might be helpful for many of you. So you can add new tag, for example, home, and you also can assign color to this tag. Okay, here we're done with tags, and let's go to the sidebar, where we can choose what we want to see on our actually sidebar here. So I don't want to see recents, I don't want to see Dropbox. I'm not use Dropbox every day probably. Applications might be helpful. Desktop, documents, okay. Downloads, okay. Movies, music, pictures, nope. Home folder, probably I don't want to see it here. iCloud drives, if you use iCloud, probably it might be helpful for you, but yeah, let's leave it here. Main machine, it's hard disks, external disks. Okay, let's leave it. If we connect external disk, it will populate here, will show up on this sidebar. CD, DVD, it's like a something from the past, it's like an ancient technology, but I want to see it here. Cloud storage, nope. Bonjour computers, it's like your computer starts scanning nearby computers and will show list of those computers here. For most of you, it's probably not helpful a lot. And connected server, I will leave that check because I have Synology NAS in my network, and when I connect to this NAS, it will show up here. And recent text, I don't want to see recent text here. We're done with sidebar, and let's move forward with the advanced tab, and let's see, let's check this checkbox, show all file names, extensions. I mean, it's helpful. I don't know why Windows, macOS trying to hide extensions of files. It's kind of helpful so you know what type of this file store, for example, in your download folder. Is it PNG, GPG, or whatever? So I usually check this checkbox. Show warning, I mean, it's okay. Remove items from the trash. Yeah, let's check it. I usually do it manually, but why not? And another one I want to check. So these settings will change order of sorting files and folders. So I want to see first folders instead of files. Let's check this and check this also. And when performing search, this kind of important, let me show what does it mean. So when you go to the downloads folder and you try to find something inside this folder, you go here and you start typing, and it starts searching in this Mac, in entire computer. I don't know why it's default settings, but it's not useful. So let's go and change that. I prefer to search in the current folder, and it's like much more logical. Okay, we're done with the Finder settings, and let's actually see what we can do with the view menu. I usually want to see path bar, so it's actually show where we are now. Also, I want to see status bar, it show us items, how many items, for example, we can count here, it's 41 items, it's files and folders in this folder application. It's quite useful. What else we can change here? We also can customize toolbar, and I usually add path to it, and I usually add get info for the files. And moreover, we can add to this toolbar wherever we want. Okay, now we have calculator here, so it's just for quick access. And another approach with a toolbar you can use, if for example you work on some project and you have a folder for this project and you want to collect all the files to this folder, you can just add this folder to the toolbar like that, and then you can drag and drop everything you want to this folder, and when you're done you can just remove it from there. Another cool feature of the Finder, it's a smart folders. Basically, it saved search query for your files. So for example, let's create smart folder which is organizing our DMG files from downloads folder. Doing that, let's go to the file, new smart folder, press here DMG, disk image. And here we see, here's the all the DMG files from the downloads folder. Let's hit save. Let's rename it to DMG. And we want to see this smart folder in our sidebar. Let's hit save. Every time we download DMG files, we can find it here. So basically you can create a smart folder for wherever you want. For example, you want to collect PDF files from entire computer, or you want to collect PDFs from shared folder from your server or NAS, or you want to collect all the photos with a certain text, for example, vacation, in a folder here. And it's so powerful and so flexible, so I highly recommend to use that to organize your files. If you recently switched from Windows to macOS, you might be surprised to find that macOS doesn't have the cut and paste feature. In Windows, familiar commands like Ctrl X and Ctrl V let you move files from one folder to another. In macOS, it works a little bit differently. To move files or folder from one folder to another, you have to choose what you want to move, press Command C, then switch to another folder where you want to put those objects, and press Command Option V. Doing that, you're moving files from one folder to another. And by the way, you can cancel that just pressing Command Z. The next useful tip. So let's say you need to move those files into a new folder. Instead of creating a new folder and dragging files into this newly created folder, you can just select objects you want to move into the folder and then press New Folder with selection. And then you need to just rename this folder and you're good to go. Sometimes you need to access to system or hidden files which are not visible by default. To show them, press Command-Shift-Period. And there you have it. All the hidden and system files are now visible just like that. If you know the exact folder you want to go, you can manually enter its path. Just press Command-Shift-G and start typing the path to the folder. Remember, typing tilde slash takes you to your home folder. And you're here. Here's some useful keyboard shortcuts for faster navigation in your file system. For example, if you press Command 1, Command 2, Command 3, or Command 4, you can change the view of your Finder, but I highly recommend you to use List View. In that case, you can use keyboard navigation easily. For example, if you want to open this folder, you can press right arrow, or you can press Command down to go to the deeper level of your file system, or if you want to go back, you can press Command up. Next quick keyboard combination is Shift Command C. It's transferring you to highest level of your file system. Here you can see all your hard drives and mounted network drives. Next key combination is Command Option L. It's transferring you to downloads folder. Next one, Command Shift D. It's a desktop. Command Shift F. It's a recent. Command Shift H. It's your home folder. Command Shift I. Your iCloud drive. Command Shift R. It's AirDrop. Command Shift U. It's utilities folder. So another useful feature of Finder is batch renaming of files. So you can choose several files, right click and choose rename. And here you can choose how you want to rename your files. You can replace text, for example, here we can see recording, and we can replace word recording to something else, or we can add some text before name or after name, and we can see result after we did that, or we can completely change format how it's named. For example, we can add name and counter, name and date, name and index, and here we can see how files will be named after that. So it's quite useful. Okay, lastly, in future, I often use as a quick actions. It's quite handy when I download image and it turns out this image it's in this weird WEBP format like that. So instead of searching same picture in a different format or use something like a Photoshop or another converter, I can just press right click, choose quick actions and convert image. And here I can choose which format I want to. And what size? Let's choose actual size and convert into the PNG. And here we see the same image, but in the format we need. And also these quick actions offer some more features, for example, remove background, create PDF, markup, and just rotate. Quite useful, quite handy, and saves a lot of time. And with that, we can conclude the overview of Finder. Well, guys, as you can see, Finder is actually not that bad. And I hope this video helps you use it much more effectively, and see you in the next part. And it's gonna be ultimate review of the file managers, and I'll tell you about my favorite one. Hit like and subscribe so you don't miss that. Thanks for watching. Bye.